If there is a purpose, the moment you take, if, for example, the other side, if there is a purpose to build a temple, immediately, ah, Vigraha has come, 10% work is over, and now, oh, this has come, 20% work is over. By the time you finish 50% work, you are already tired. Oh, such a big thing I achieved in my age, who can do all these things? For my age, the work which I am doing is too big. All this nonsense will start building up in your mind. And you will start thinking you have done a big thing. People always come and tell me, oh Swamiji, for your age, you are having one ashram in India, one ashram in America, one here, one there, they go on talking. And I tell, what is the whole purpose? Nothing. Simply nothing. And I tell you one more thing, just like all other organizations, the moment I die, this also will become one more mission. All politics, all problem, everything will come. As long as I am alive, things can go. Maybe I can keep little purity. The moment I leave the body, the whole thing will become again the same old nonsense. I know the whole thing. So there is no purpose. As long as I am there, I may share this enlightenment with a few hundred people or a few thousand people. Just for this, the whole thing is running. That's all. Otherwise, the whole thing is just pure drama. Because I am very clear about this, I don't feel I am doing a big job. I don't have the concept building in me, oh, for my age, I did this much, I did that, this has happened, that has happened. Because I understand that is not getting built. Because that is not getting built, I am not feeling tired. I don't have tiredness. I don't feel that I have done some big thing, first thing. Next thing, I don't feel I should stop somewhere. Neither I have ego, nor I have tiredness. Ego creates deep tiredness in you. The moment you think you have done something, you are already tired. The restlessness has started. I know the whole thing, how the whole thing will go. And after me, what will happen? The whole thing I know. Some fool will catch this throne and start claiming he is my representative. And all these things are usual drama. And I know the whole thing. And after game also, before game and after game. Because I know the whole thing, I don't bother. And the whole thing is just, at least few people can have this experience. What has happened in me, if I can reproduce in some people, then the purpose is over. That is not even a purpose. That's just a meaning. If you can catch this fire, the big fire is burning. Whoever want, they can catch it in their life. This is the whole thing, that's all. And all other thing is just drama to substitute this whole thing. Yes.
In the context of purpose and purposelessness, what is the difference between animals and human beings?
Be very clear, animals are not conscious beings. They can't understand there is something like a purpose or purposelessness. You are a conscious being. You can understand the whole thing is purposeless and start enjoying. Animals are in instinct level. Man is in intellectual level. Man can understand purpose and purposelessness. Man who has completely realized purposelessness, he becomes intelligent level. Animal is instinct. It can neither understand nor practice. Man is in intellectual level. He can understand, practice. Person who has achieved the purposelessness, realized the truth of purposelessness, he is in the intelligence level. So,
How does purposelessness and chronological planning go together?
Be very clear. The moment you understand the purposelessness, the first one or two days, your mind will refuse even the chronological planning. It will resist. Whenever you say some truth to a child, it will try its best to resist you. It will try its best to go to the other extreme, just to tease you. Same way the mind will try to tease you. Let it tease you for few days. Allow. Don't bother. Then automatically your intelligence will start working. The chronological planning will simply happen. First thing, it's like this story. One born blind person, he went to the doctor and asked, "Doctor, can you cure me?" Doctor said, "Yes, I can do an operation. You will have your eyes back. Then you can walk without stick. The stick which the blind people use." The blind guy asked, "Doctor, I understand you will do an operation. I understand I will have my eyes back. But how can I walk without stick?" "Can you convince him intellectually you can walk without stick before the operation?" "No, because his mind is associated, his walk, he can walk only with a stick. Only after the operation he can understand, he doesn't need stick. Only if you allow this purposelessness inside you, you will understand you don't need mind to live. You don't need mind to live. You don't need mind to exist. You can exist, you can live beautifully, blissfully without mind. Mind is like that stick. There is no need for you to have the mind to walk. But you need to have a little bit of patience till I finish the operation." The operation is nothing but understanding the purposelessness. Understand it completely, intensely. Suddenly, this moment you will feel the liberation. Even the liberation is purposeless. What will you do? Tell me. Even if you are liberated. Now I am liberated. What is there? I am here, that's all. You are there, I am here, nothing else. What is there? Nothing else. That's all. Then what for you have to suffer? What for you have to struggle? There is nothing. Somebody goes to Ravana Maharshi and asks, "Bhagavan, give me a little vibhuti." Bhagavan says, "That is there, take it." In front of him, in the coconut shell, the vibhuti was there. Take it. No, from Bhagavan's hand we need. Are this hand and that hand is one and the same, take it. Understand, it's a Zen answer. Only a courageous master can Bhagavan can give these answers. He says, "This hand and that hand is one and the same, take it. There is nothing." But very difficult to understand. We always think, no. How can this hand and that hand be one and the same? If you poke a knife in that hand and this hand, same blood will come. You think just because I am enlightened, blood will not come? Nothing. All I have is this understanding. And have this understanding, that's enough. And you may think, say, no, you have some extraordinary things. You are doing this, you are doing that. This all will start happening in you the moment you understand. This is not happening around you because you have not understood. That's all. I always tell people, this is a very bold statement I can make. Honest truth. I have all the problems which you have. When I say all, A-L-L, capital letter. I have all the problems which you have. Whether outer world or inner world. The only one thing. I know the whole thing is purposeless. That's all. You do not know that. That's all. Experientially I know the whole thing is purposeless. Just if this moment when I close my eyes, I can see millions of universes are getting created and disappearing into this cosmic ocean. Millions of jagats are getting created and millions are disappearing. I know that. Experientially I know. That's the reason I am completely relaxed. You and me, there is no difference, only one thing. I know that the whole thing is purposeless, you are not able to understand, that's all. Nothing else. All you need to do is just understand the whole thing is purposeless. Millions of universes are getting created, millions of planets are appearing and millions are disappearing. The Big Bang and black hole is continuously happening. In that, we are doing this small drama of having one small planet Earth. In that one planet Earth, making big boundary and big state, country, immigration, visa, all this nonsense. And in that, one plot land, fence, the whole thing. Whole nonsense is going on. his embassy, his country, so many, whole drama. But the whole thing is just one planet Earth, not even lemon size. No, not even lemon size. Now, I am not asking you to believe the spirituality, see even astronomically. Again and again, the scientists are telling somewhere Big Bang is going on, somewhere black hole is going on. Just 6 months ago, they caught the photograph of black hole, you know. Any of you saw that first time they caught, they photographed black hole. So many universes disappearing, so many planets disappearing into one small hole, and that hole also disappears. Where? Nobody knows. Because the frequency of time is totally different. Actually, the black hole is not disappearing. It is moving to the different frequency of time. After that, they can't see. They can't photograph. They say it is disappeared. It has not disappeared. It has gone to different frequency. Continuously, Big Bang is happening and black hole is happening. And in that Big Bang, one solar family, in that one small planet Earth. And now suddenly, I heard that 1 month ago, they discovered one more planet. Now, not Navagraha, Dasagraha now. Now, I have to make one more statue. Suddenly, 1 month ago, only these guys have discovered. And they said, 2 more sun is there. And what to do? Which sun they are worshipping, we don't know. And one day we are doing Surya Namaskar. Which sun we are doing, we don't know. The whole thing is now in confusion. And which side to look now, which sun to worship, we don't know. And if you worship this sun, that sun will become angry, we don't know. And the whole thing is just purposeless. And with this we are making such big huge theories, political philosophies, spiritual philosophies. The whole thing is going on. It's like a huge soap bubble. One soap bubble was little top of all the other soap bubble. Started claiming, hey, you are all my citizens. Sit around. I am your king. See, there are many guys who are claiming that they are kings. Somebody came and asked me, Swami, I saw a guy in the asylum. He thinks he's a king. What to do? You see, he thinks he's a king, but he's not cunning enough to make others believe. Or he's not violent enough to torture others if you don't believe what I say is true. That's why he's in asylum. The guy who is cunning enough to make others believe that he is king, or who is cunning enough to frighten others, if you don't believe what I say, I'll torture you. He is in the throne, that's all. In the throne or in the asylum, both are same. The one who is ready to torture others, the one who is violent enough to threaten others to believe his words, he is sitting in the throne. The one who is not that much cunning, simple innocent guy, he is in the asylum. Otherwise, both beliefs are one and the same. That fellow's belief and this fellow's belief, both are one and the same. What will you do? Nothing. Nothing is, the whole thing is just purposeless. Yes. What do you want to know by knowing the what he is?
Because the thing frightens that something eternal is. So
that's what I'm saying. Your ego cannot be alive without some base. I'm just pulling the base. I'm just taking the whole base. And you are saying what? Then what for I'm running? Then what for I'm running? You are not able to understand. You are running like a fool. Your whole running is a pure foolishness. I am telling you, the whole running is just pure foolishness. Of course, even if you are haunted by the person, let you be haunted, what is the wrong? Let you suffer, nothing wrong. Either you learn from me or the life will teach you, that's all. See, learn from master or life will teach. Nothing else to be done. Even if you don't learn from me, I have no problem. Life will teach you. Life will teach. The sufferings from life will teach the truth, nothing else.
You said you are building these offers to share your enlightenment. That sounds like a purpose to me.
No, be very clear. Even if nobody becomes enlightened, I will not feel suffering. I will not suffer. I won't suffer if nobody receives enlightenment also. The bliss is just radiating. The joy is just radiating. If somebody catches, let him catch. Otherwise, let him go. That's all. I have no problem. If I have that as a purpose, if nobody becomes enlightened, I'll feel disturbed, depressed. And naturally, I'm not going to feel that. Not only I'm not going to feel that, from beginning I'm very clear. From beginning, I'm very clear. Not only that, even now, I'm very clear. I'm sitting here, I'm shouting whole day. Tomorrow, people will be the same old persons. That also I know. They will go back and do the same thing. After 1 month, when they come back for some meeting or some program, I'll ask them, are you meditating? Oh, I have to start, Swamiji. So much of work, na? My mother-in-law came from India. So I have to send my daughter and I have to take care of these. I'll start next month, Swamiji. I know that. Whole drama. Anyhow, I am feeling joyful, ecstatic, that blissful. Let it radiate, that's all. Whoever wants to catch, let them catch, that's all. So there is no purpose. I can say it's like a beyond me, it is just oozing out. It's just oozing out. So be very clear. Yes.
Somebody, you said that
That is what I am saying. The moment you understand the purposelessness, enlightenment will happen. You can't achieve. If enlightenment becomes one more purpose, you can't achieve it. That is what I meant when I said that word.
Swamiji, to understand the purposelessness, you need to have a trust and surrendering.
Now don't bring new big words, ma'am. Some more big words.
Understand.
Only when you understand the purposelessness, the surrender and trust will start happening. One more thing. Whether you surrender or trust, the purposelessness is the truth. Whether the bubble understands the bubble, there is no need for bubble to surrender. Because there is nothing to surrender. What big thing you have in your life, tell me to surrender. Always this kind, guys come and tell me, Swamiji, I surrendered everything at your feet. Please take care. What you have? Worthy thing, tell me. What worthy thing you have to surrender? Nothing is there. Simply 2-3 stones. See, the grind sand, beach grind sand, that and a diamond, both are one and the same. Only one thing, there are many fools who are interested in possessing the diamond. That is why it has got market value. That's all. Otherwise, the bubble, the stone which is lying in the beach and the stone which is in your locker, both are one and the same. Yes.
How do you explain the power of the karma and all these other concepts that you discussed yesterday and today?
From yesterday, I was preparing you to bring you to this understanding. Straight away in the first lecture, if I tell this, you will run away. Straight away, if I tell this in the first lecture, what you will do? I think this Swami is up to something. This is not for me. And by now, at least you are ready to understand. This little sane guy. Now you are ready to believe that whatever I am saying is, there is some truth behind those words. Now I am coming out with a clear truth. Yes, please, please. Please do not blame me. I have not put your made it. Understand. This moment you understand. That's all. Don't make this as one more purpose. I told somebody, accept yourself as you are. He said, no, Swamiji, I am not able to accept. I don't know, at least accept that you are not able to accept. That is at least you. At least accept that you are not able to accept.